All people come to him, come to the way of Sultan Al-Anbiya, most honored one and most glorified one.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, كل عمل لا يبدأ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فهو أبتر. Any meeting or any association or anything you do, if you don't say بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, that عمل is cut down. No progress in it. So always, whenever you have to recite or read or speak or lectures or advice or eating or drinking or going out of the house, running the car, doing any job or doing anything, you begin with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. If you don't say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, that amal, no continuation, it will stop as it is when you said it, and it doesn't grow. We need our amal to grow up, inshallah, in ascension always, especially ibadah. Yaqul, Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul, he is 39 on the golden chain, number 39 on the golden chain. He used to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected for many heavenly years when Allah created the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that nur, that no one knows what a kind of nur is that. It's khas, it's private to Prophet only. Only Prophet, what is the source of that nur? Al-Nur al-Muhammadi. When he created that nur, he put it in a fi bahr al-Qudra, in the ocean of power. And that nur was turning. And he said it was turning 500 years, 5 times. Means 2,500 heavenly years. That nur was turning. And after that nur still turning till the day of judgment, producing sources of light different for every abid, for every person of Ummatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When that 2,500 years, heavenly years, gone, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was revealed to him the reality of hadith, Addabani Rabbi fa ahsana ta'diwi. Allah perfected my soul, Allah perfected me, Addabani Rabbi, Allah perfected me, and He perfected me the best way could be. So Prophet ﷺ, first thing from that nur that was turning 2,500 years, he said, Addabani Rabbi. The first thing he said, Allah perfected me. So adab, that's why they say, adab with you have to have adab with everything, from adab to respect people, to respect humanity, to respect awliyaullah, to respect sahaba, to respect, to love Prophet, to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to respect them. And that respect is not to say I respect or I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you love Allah, you do what Allah wants you to do. when you do what Allah wants you to do, then you are taking from the secret, inheriting from the secret of adab of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why أدبني ربي فأحسن تأديبي. He perfected me and perfected me highly, confirming that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has respected him and perfected him, and Prophet saying that Allah perfected me to his ummah, to know that he has been honored with that respect. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, someone has adab, he take his amal with adab. He will not throw it in his face. Means our amal can be thrown away from our faces. وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. We come to what they have done and we throw it in their faces. If that amal is not perfected and is not for Allah but for yourself. So we have to be careful to identify our, to tell our nafs that every amal we are doing is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why ita'atullah is wajiba, obligatory. Like in the army, they tell you when order comes, you have to do, you have no way to ask question in the army. The soldiers has to respect their leaders and do what they are asking them to do. In the course of life, Ibadullah has to obey whatever order comes. You like it or you don't like it. You have to obey it. Allah says, إنما الخمر والميسر والأزلام رجس والأنصاب رجس من عمل الشيطان فاجتنبوه. He counted many amal that are not from Allah or from Shaitan, for you have to be away from them. So if you do them, then you have a problem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfect us.
Amen.
Allah said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا يُطْعِمُونَ إِنَّ اللَّهُ وَالرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Holy Quran, I created ins and jinn only to worship me. Nothing else. You sit in your home, if you really, after that ayah, now might be some people might say no, there is interpretation or tafsir of that ayah. But in its literary meaning, you have to know that Allah has created ins and jinn only to worship. And worshipness is the ibadah what Allah ordered you to do. And worshipness also in the 24 hours, 8 hours worshipness, 8 hours sleeping, 8 hours socializing with your family, work and socializing. So you have 8 hour ibadah every day, 8 hour socializing with your family and you are working, and 8 hours sleeping. This is, these three will be considered ibadah if you are doing them accordingly and perfecting them. Even you sleep, Allah will reward you because you are sleeping in order to get power to do next day what ibadah has to do, to do of your awrad and your ibadah, and to work in order to give to your family. If you do that, you are under khitab, under the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where he said, وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. I don't want from them for rizq. I will provide rizq to everyone. But I want from them to understand and to believe. May Allah bless our grand sheikh. May Allah bless our sheikh. May Allah bless all the shuyukh around the world and awliyaullah, because they guide their followers to the right path. Sayyidina Abdul Khaliq al-Wajdawani had a and grand sheikh, may Allah bless him, he said that story about Abdul Khaliq al-Wajdawani, one of the golden chain of the Naqshbandi order. He said he had a murid very highly respected, and he is very rich. Allah gives. إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. Allah is the Razzaq. He has the power in his hand. He was providing Sayyida Maryam inside her room with food. Whenever Sayyidina Zakaria entered her niche, he found there fruit, food. أن لك هذا يا مريم قالت هو من عند الله. From where you brought it, you didn't go out. She said, Allah send it to me. Allah send it to me. Send me this fruit. Angels will come and bringing that food to me. He was stunned. Sayyidina Zakaria is a prophet. And Sayyida Maryam is not a prophet. Some scholars, they have other opinion, but the majority, they say no. They say she was not a prophet, but she was a sadiqa, siddiqa, trustworthy one. Because it is surprising how she get that, and Sayyidina Zakaria is not getting, he is a prophet. كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا. Whenever he entered, he find rizq there. He is astonished, surprised. So what he said? قال أن لك هذا يا مريم. قالت هو من عند الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, provide anyone without asking. That's why لا تكثر لهمك ما قدر يكون والله المقدر والعالم شؤون. الذي لغيرك لا يصل إليك.
الذي قسم لك
حافظ لديك. How you are memorizing. Whatever is being written for you, you are getting it. You cannot get anything that doesn't belong to you, even your bite. If Allah doesn't want you to eat your bite, to give it to someone else, He will do it to someone else. Might be someone else will. Sometimes you look at a plate and there is something you like there, but you cannot reach. And you say, I want to take it, so you extend your spoon and someone else takes it. What do you do? It's gone. Allah wanted that rizq for that person, not for you. He gives you, He gives him, whatever He gives, Allah huwa al-aati. He is the one that gives. نحن والخلائق كلنا عبيد والإله فينا يفعل ما يريد. We and the creation, all of us, we are His abid, His servants. والإله فينا, and Allah with us, يفعل ما يريد, will do whatever He wants. He created us, He wrote what we need to do in dunya, what we need to eat, what we need to drink, how old are we. Awliya Allah, they don't count by years. 70 years, 80 years. They count by moments their lives because they are always thinking about death. When you think about death, and it is advice from Awliyaullah that always in 24 hours, Awliyaullah, they recommend that their student will meditate for even 1 minute or 2 minutes to remember that they are going to die at any moment. So by this way, you save yourself from shaitan, from Iblis. Because if you want to do something wrong, you remember that you might die at that moment. And you, Sayyidina Malakul Maut will take your soul, and you are in this bad sin, you are falling into bad sin, then you are going to be asked and be responsible for what you have done. So they recommend at least 4 times in 24 hours to remember death. That's why in Salatul Fajr, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Sunnatul Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, between Sunnah and Fard, he used to lay down on his side, right side, thinking about death. That one day I am going to leave dunya. So ulama'ul ummah and awliya'ul ummah, they recommend to between sunnat al-fajr and fard al-fajr to lay down on our right hand on the floor or on the prayer rugs or whatever, and remember that we are going to die. For awliyaullah, not 4 times a day, but every moment they see death in front of them. They have you know that when they read the news today, they have this technology.
News bulletin,
you can see in front of the one who is reading the news. He looks at the
teleprompter.
They read, it's written there and it's moving. Subhanallah. And if an invention of a human being, you get these letters by energy, in an electric way. So it's with that light, you can see the letters being written with the light that comes on the screen, and you read it. What you think about awliyaullah, they cannot read your heart like that. If in dunya they can read MRI, ultrasound, what else you have, x-rays, what doctor you have more?
They're useless.
They can read all this by electromagnetic waves. And when you say a wali can see and can hear, they say no, objection. And Allah says in holy hadith that as long as my servant approaches me, I will be his ears that he can hear with, I will be his eyes that he can see with. So how? مَزَالَ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبُّهُ فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُ كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ وَبَصَرُهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ. I will be his ears that he can hear with, I will be his eyes that he can see with. So it means اتقوا فراسة المؤمن فأنه ينظر بنور الله. Be aware of the vision of the believer, because he is looking with the light that Allah gave to his heart. So it means like laser, how it break everything and reach its goal. When you have, especially in medicine, now they are curing people with laser for stones or something else, I don't know, they know, doctors knows that. So if awliyaullah, they don't have a laser that Allah gave to their eyes, And Allah said in this holy hadith to Prophet revealed that I will be their ears that they can hear with, I will be their eyes that they can see. So why we are not seeing? Because we are not struggling with our ego and remembering that every moment. Awliya Allah, they remember that every moment in their lives. So they can read the hearts of the believer as Prophet and a non-believer, as Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, اتَّقُوا فِرَاسَةَ الْمُؤْمِنِ. Be aware of the vision of the believer. Because he looks with the light that Allah gave to his eyes. Means can see everything transparent to him. But for us, we don't see it transparent. Veiled. We can see a block. I can see now Shahabuddin sitting there. I can see. I cannot see through him. But if a wali was sitting here, can see through him. There is no obstacle. That body form become like subtle form for a wali. And he can see his follower even from far east to far west. Allah will give. When Allah gives, he doesn't ask me or you to ask anyone else. He is the commander. He is the creator. He does what he wants. But we have to remember that if I am attempting to do something that is bad, I have to understand that might be as during what I am doing this bad action, angel of death comes and taking my soul, how I am going to be in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Am I going to be punished or not? If Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying to Sayyida Aisha, Ya Aisha, make dua that Allah will not judge you. Yeah. Wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wife of Prophet, that she gave her life to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Sayyidina Muhammad used to love her the most. She and Fatima al-Zahra, daughter of Prophet. Sayyida Aisha and Sayyida Fatima. He says to her, ask Allah not to judge you. Hey Aisha, Allah will judge her. She is the wife of Prophet. But the Prophet is concerned to make sure that Sayyida Aisha will be perfected. For us to learn that if our mother of heavens, Sayyida Aisha, mother of all mu'mins, Ummul Mu'mineen, if Prophet is telling her not to ask, not to be judged, what about us? If we are going to be judged, what will happen to us? Awliya Allah, they are afraid from that load, heavy load that they carry from their followers, because they are under responsibility when they give them a bay'ah, when they take their hand to guide them, they are responsible to take them to a safety shore. So they are afraid, they carry that load on their shoulders. So don't be a sheikh. Don't be a shepherd, be a sheep. It's better. Don't say, I know, and try to please your ego where you don't know anything. Allah said, وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ. Above every knower there is a knower. I'm saying wrong, something wrong. What they say, send to me, I'm saying. So he said, don't be sleeping on silk. Now we are sleeping on mattresses that they are silk. I don't know in the future if they will do mattresses from gold. Everyone is running to get a mattress that has remote control, has a memory, has a coolant, and has a heater in it. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to sleep on a straw, a mattress from straw. It's not? When he sleep on such a mattress, how his back will be? All marks. Yeah, that's why you are a doctor. All marks. We are not happy with our mattress. Everyone will say, oh, this is not good mattress. This is not good mattress. They are selling mattresses $10,000 these days. Tomorrow, what they are going to do? Let them try a mattress from straw is better. Tibin. In Arabic, tibin. Straw is tibin. So he said to her, Ya Aisha, man husib, uzib. Anyone who will be judged, for sure he will be punished. Allah will bring something that is hidden to him. Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul, As-Sadiq. He is Sadiq, he is trustworthy one, very well known between his people and his followers in Dagestan and in Russia at that time, Sheikh Abdullah Dagestani. He said in Rashadiya, when they migrated from Dagestan to Turkey, there is a village outside Istanbul called Rashadiya. It's after Izmit, after Yalova. There was an imam, very good imam, alim. Always his khutbah on Jum'ah or advice, always making people to be khaifin.
Afraid.
Warning them, all his lecture, Naziran, 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 no Bashiran. Naziran means warning, 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 warning. Prophet, he said, Naziran wa Bashiran, Bashiran wa Naziran. Give good tidings and warnings. But for the Ummah, must be between each other when they speak, must be good tidings. Warning is by Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You cannot warn people. You can advise people, but not warn means you are seeing yourself better than them. When you warn someone, means you have to apply it on yourself first, then you warn the other one. If Prophet saying to Sayyidina Aisha, Ya Aisha, من حوسب عذب. Anyone who been judged going to be punished because Allah will get him to be punished. He will bring for him amal that he forgot about it, that was not accepted, and a sin that was committed. And then he will judge him very heavily, like what happened to that Sheikh Imam in Rashadiya, in the village of Grand Sheikh. He said one day that Imam was warning his follower after Fajr prayer that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to punish you, you are doing sins, you are not worthy of to go to paradise, you have to do this, you have to stop that. He was, all his lectures make everyone to be يعني going to run away. So it was a confusion between the people who were listening. That night the Imam at Fajr time came, but he was wrapping his face completely with a sheet or towel, covering his beard, only showing his eyes and his nose, and covering himself, and saying to them, for my 70 years that I am living with you, I was warning you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But tonight, I received something that made me to say to you, I'm not going to warn you anymore. I'm going to tell you about Allah's mercy. His mercy is overwhelming. وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. My mercy has encompassed everything. He said, when I was sleeping, I saw a dream, a vision. It's between sleep and yaqaza and awake, it's a vision that a voice came and an angel came, or an order came to angel, bring that sheikh to be questioned. Allah wants to question this sheikh. He's seeing in the dream, he's not seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he's hearing an angelic voice. Bring him. And he was present, and he was said to him, Naziran, to warn people only to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That khasa'isun Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is privacy for Prophet only. To warn people. To advise people is for everyone. Where you have put my mercy, O you, that person, where you put my mercy aside, and you are only 70 years teaching people, to warning them about from me, instead of pouring love to their hearts about me, why you are teaching them to be away from me and running from me by fear? Why you didn't show them love and mercy to come more nearer and nearer? So I am sending you to hellfire. He said a huge flame came from hellfire, took his beard completely, his eyebrows, everything on his face. And when he woke up from the dream, afraid, and he found there is no more beard, it's been burned. This Allah's teaching, interfering with Allah, Allah will do whatever He wants. Don't say, oh, this is not true. We believe in our shuyukh. Their stories are full of wisdoms. And many things happen in dunya that we cannot understand, but they understand. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah brought him to Mi'raj, he understand the most. So, من حسب عذب. Anyone who he was addressed them, that Prophet addressing Sayyida Aisha, that من حسب عذب, anyone who will be judged, he's going to be punished. It is khasiyatu Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's privacy for Prophet to do warning. So that applies to us. We have to ask Allah after every prayer that, Ya Rabbi, don't judge us with your mercy. As you gave that teaching to that man in his vision, in his dream, We, Ya Rabbi, we are asking you to forgive us and to provide us with what you like for us. Because when you become entering the struggling with your ego and entering the divine presence, you begin to understand the reality of every hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and what it means. Until then, we have to struggle. So Allah created ins and jinn only to worship. I don't want from him, he said, any kind of rizq. I will provide them. They cannot provide themselves. I will provide them. And rizq is always is like a chain. Everyone has a chain on his head. Yani it's hablur rizq, the rope of rizq, the rope of sustenance. Everyone has a rope connected to the source of sustenance that Allah has given from that particular place that assigned to that person that he will get his rizq. It will be coming on that rope of sustenance, coming to the head of the person, and he will see it in dunya. If you make sadaqah, cut and help the other people whom they have short ropes, they cannot touch, means they are poor. If you work and help them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you twice. He will reward you as you gave a gift to that poor guy, and he reward you that you are a generous person, and that rizq will come back, that rope will come and come on your head. So حبل الرزق لا ينقطع, the rope of sustenance never is cut. Always it's descending on your head. Allah open doors, you don't know what kind of doors Allah will open for you. Only you have to be certain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to provide you with rizq. So Sayyidina Abdul Khaliq al-Ghujdwani used to have a murid that is very rich. We begin that story, the sahaba with that story, is very rich, and he was devoted to Sayyidina Abdul Khaliq al-Ghujdwani a lot. So he was ordered to go into seclusion. And in that seclusion, what will happen, we will see next time, inshallah. Tomorrow. We will speak about that story of rizq, story of rizq. To see how Allah provides His servants. وَمِنَ اللَّهِ التَّوْفِيقِ Be is a simple English. We are not after English language, but for people to understand, we have the minimum kind of English, no problem, because I am coming old now, so I'm talking less quiet, hiding my voice. So forgive me and pray for me, all of you who are seeing us and who are not seeing us, can be seeing us later, inshallah. May Allah bless you all. Allah is the Razzaq. Don't worry about your rizq. Allah will provide it to you, to your home, to your mouth, to your children, to your family. But keep confident in Allah's. When He promised, He promised. When He say, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ الرزق. I don't want, I created them for worshipness, I don't want from them anything, I will provide them. May Allah provide us from the two knowledge, two oceans, the ocean of spiritual knowledge and the ocean of the physical knowledge. And physical food and spiritual food. May Allah protect you and protect me and protect us, and may Allah bring happiness and peacefulness to this universe, because it is this what is going on now. It's indicate of the signs of the last days, and we are seeing what happening with Europe now. Now it's going to be divided and divided and divided. May Allah make peace everywhere and make unity everywhere. ومن الله التوفيق بحرمة الفاتحة.